As you know, a healthy lifestyle helps prevent a multitude of health issues, including, for example, high cholesterol. But now the unimaginable. This morning, in our ongoing series, Behind the Mystery, Rare and Genetic Diseases, we're going to discuss an inherited condition which can be extremely dangerous and sometimes even deadly. Our guest this morning is Dr. Pam Morris, a cardiologist with the Medical University of South Carolina. Good
Great.
Morning, doctor.
So good to see you.
I'm so glad you're here. Let's get to it. Let's first talk about cholesterol. What causes it and what can be done when you have it?
Well, first, it's important to recognize that there are two types of cholesterol. Mm-hmm. The HDL, which is the good cholesterol,
the happy cholesterol,
mm-hmm. which you would like to be high. It helps to clear cholesterol. And the second is the LDL cholesterol, which is the bad form of cholesterol.
Lousy. That's how
you want that low. And that type is the type of cholesterol that can, when at elevated levels, can circulate through the bloodstream and cause heart and vascular disease. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, for many people, diet and exercise are not always enough to get these levels down.
And why is that?
Well, some individuals have a rare or uncommon form of high cholesterol that it is inherited. This is called familial hypercholesterolemia, and there are two types. In the first type, you inherit only one gene from one parent that is abnormal.
Okay.
That is called heterozygous FH, heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia. The second type is when you inherit an abnormal gene
from
both of your parents. We call this homozygous FH or HoFH. The signs and symptoms are very difficult to diagnose and may be silent.
And how do you know if you have it, for example?
Well, first, it's important that it be recognized and that you work with a cardiologist or lipidologist who specializes in this disorder. They're going to look at four things. Number one, do you have a family history of high cholesterol or heart and vascular disease? Second, what are your personal cholesterol levels? Are they elevated? Third, they're going to look for physical findings. Do you have deposits of cholesterol in the tendons of the knees, the elbows, the Achilles, or around the eyes?
Hmm.
And finally, they're going to look to see how well do you respond to traditional cholesterol-lowering medications.
Doctor, what if you have all four, or let's just say you have two out of the four?
Well, it's not necessary to have all four criteria. There's quite a variability in the presentation and diagnosis of HoFH.
And if you do have this uncommon genetic disorder, is there something people can do to help control it?
Well, of course, we do always begin with diet and exercise because it can always be of some help. For some individuals, we'll try what's called LDL apheresis. Think of it as almost like dialysis for cholesterol, but that's time consuming, and the centers that perform this procedure are not widely available.
Doctor, is there anything else that can be done, let's say medications?
Well, now there are novel therapies for patients with HoFH, so it's a very exciting time for these individuals.
I gotta tell you, this is great and exciting information. I want you to stay right there, doctor, because when we come back, we're gonna put a face to this condition. You're gonna meet an incredible young lady with an amazing story to tell, so stay right there. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the show. Before the break, we were discussing HoFH, a rare disease that results in high cholesterol. We are rejoined by Dr. Pam Morris, a cardiologist with the Medical University of South Carolina, and also now joining us are 20-year-old Amanda Willson and Catherine Wallman, who is the president of the FH Foundation. Ladies, thank you so much for joining us. Doctor, thank you for joining me again. Amanda, let me start with you. When did you find out you had this rare disease?
Well, I was diagnosed at age 3, and it was found by my pediatrician. I went into my well checkup at age 3, and he found the cholesterol deposits on my Achilles tendon behind the knee and also between my fingers. My grandfather had it. He found out he was diagnosed at 59, and he was diagnosed and went through triple bypass surgery the same year. At that point, my parents were just getting ready to be married, and my dad was diagnosed at 29. My mom was also later diagnosed.
Doctor, let me bring you back in, because it's funny, when I knew Amanda was coming to talk to us, I pictured, honestly, you know, somebody older, overweight, you know, I guess she didn't fit the profile that I was thinking of.
The face of this condition can vary from anything from a young child diagnosed as Amanda was in childhood to a young adult, such as with Catherine, where the disease is missed until you present with your first heart or vascular event.
Catherine, let me bring you in. As the doctor just mentioned about a heart event, something happened to you at the age of 39. What happened? And it's actually startling to hear this.
Well, I had a heart attack.
Wow.
And when it happened, I called 911. I knew something was wrong. The paramedics came. I told them about my elevated cholesterol. They took me to the emergency room, and the emergency room turned me away. Luckily, when I finally did get in surgery, you know, I'm here to live to tell about it. But the interesting thing is there was a barrier because I didn't look like someone who had advanced heart disease.
But you know, doctor, and if I can ask you this, it's pretty serious. I mean, this is just not you'll get over it, move on, and that's it.
Well, I think sometimes we can underestimate the risk and danger associated with high cholesterol. And HoFH is a life-threatening disease. We're very fortunate to be here with individuals who are receiving the proper treatment.
Catherine, I know as a result of what happened to you, you've started the foundation to create awareness, and God bless you for that. Tell me about it.
Well, yes, it's called the FH Foundation, and we're the only nonprofit out there exclusively dedicated to raising awareness of FH, both HoFH and the more common form of familial hypercholesterolemia. And we're doing this through education, advocacy, and research, because the startling fact is that more than 80% of the individuals who have this disease are undiagnosed.
And doctor, with Catherine and Amanda speaking about it and you, this is really key to bring that awareness to everybody out there and just to learn more about this.
It's very important to be tested, particularly if you have a family history of premature heart disease or of high cholesterol. Talk with your doctor.
Amanda, I want to end with you because you're such an inspiration. Any final words?
Even though I am an HoFH patient, I still hang out with my friends, participate in sports. I am an education major at college, and this disease has not stopped me yesterday, today, and it won't stop me tomorrow.
Oh, God bless you. Good luck to you.
Thank you
so much. And if you'd like more information about HoFH and to learn what you can do to spread the word about this disease, visit a couple of websites. The first one, thefhfoundation.org, or contact the National Lipid Association at learnyourlipids.com.